Hey guys, Tiffany here of Tiffany Green Cosplay, and welcome back to the channel! If you're new here, I'd love to have you as part of our cosplay community, so like this video and subscribe to the channel. On this cosplay tutorial, I'm gonna be showing you how I made the Junker Queen X, specifically Carnage! And this is from Overwatch 2, and the best thing about this axe is it actually comes apart in two pieces, so I can travel with this. But more importantly, I can ship this to the person that commissioned it. Make sure to check out her website, Glass by Groves. She does amazing anime-inspired stained glass pieces. So check it out and let's get started. And for this build, you're gonna need quite a bit of materials and it is a little bit of a challenging build, so you are warned. But all of these are linked in the description, as well as I have a 2D blueprint for this axe, which is available on my website, www.tiffanygordoncosplay.com. Again, link in the description. To first start off, you're going to want to get insulation foam board and you're gonna trace the head of each of the blade sections onto this and then cut it out. And I highly recommend using a hot wire as this will pierce through and cut it like butter. And you're going to want to make a sharp bladed side. So for this, I kind of traced where the flat part of the axe was and did a line and then did ruler marks to the edge. So it kind of gave me a guideline of where each of the points are gonna be, followed by a guideline around the center of the edge of the axe. And this is going to be an indication of where we're going to angle our hot wire or a box cutter to cut our angle of the blade. For all of the hole pieces on the insulation foam, I used Costool's hole drills, all of their different sizes, to punch a hole and then followed up by sanding all of it smooth using a sanding drum. And for this axe, it does have some chipped parts in the blade section. And for this, I got a box cutter and cut it out. And then for the fun part, which is going to be covering the insulation foam using Warbler, specifically the black Warbler. And for doing this, we're gonna be using the sandwich method, which is where we're going to encase the insulation foam with Warbler on both sides. And for this, you're going to want to put your insulation foam on top of the Warbler and trace a little bit larger than the shape of the insulation foam. You will do this two times and then you will cut it out using scissors. And Warbler is a thermoplastic, and for it to activate, it needs to have an extremely high heat temperature. And for this, you need to use a heat gun, not a hairdryer. Applying heat to the Warbler so that way it turns from a hard surface and slowly starts to turn to a more soft surface. And when it gets to this point, you're going to put the Warbler over the insulation foam. Be aware you do not want to apply any heat to the insulation foam as the heat gun will melt this material. And slowly push the Warbler over the insulation foam part. And you can use your hands for this. Just be aware that the surface may be hot. Then we're gonna repeat this for the second side. I will note that it also attaches better when the first side is slightly hot. So make sure to apply a little bit of heat to that first, and then you will connect the two pieces and slowly start to drape them together. After your two pieces are connected, you'll still want to keep applying heat with your heat gun, but it doesn't need to be extremely hot, just enough so it's slightly soft. And then you can use a bunch of different clay tools that are flat. You can use round burnishers and kind of rub it into all of the creases and crevices to get all the details from the insulation foam to appear onto the surface. Then once you're kind of happy with how it looks, get some scissors and then cut the excess trim around the edge. I'll note that it cuts a lot easier when the Warbler is slightly heated up as well. Then to clean up the sharp edge, and again, you're gonna be using a heat gun, and this time you're gonna wanna use a flat edge tool. I use my ceramic one, and you're going to slowly smooth out that sharp point to blend it into the Warbler surface. And you just work back and forth until you are happy. Next, we're gonna grab our center frame, which is going to be a 1-inch CPVC pipe. And for this, I kind of measured where it was going to be and drew a line for where I'm gonna cut it. Because again, I do have to ship this piece, so the top part of the axe does disassemble from the main handle part, but you can leave it as one piece if you want. And for cutting, I ended up using my jeweler's saw. And this piece is going to attach the big part of the axe to it, as well as a smaller butt end on the other side. So I wanted the material to be the same. So I ended up grabbing some more Warbler and covering this part of the CPVC pipe with it, encasing it together and cleaning it up. And for attaching Warbler pieces together, you don't need to use any glue. You can just apply heat to the two surfaces that you want to attach, and while it's still hot, push the two pieces together, and then you can add a little bit of Warbler scrap around the edge, kind of blend and melt the two Warbler pieces together to fuse as one. Now for more details, and for this we're gonna again grab our Cost Tools hole drills and apply a little bit of heat to the Warbler. And then while it's still hot, you can push and make indentations with your round little jump rings and everything that you want to have on the outside parts. And then I added more details again with a heat gun, as well as using some other clay tools to add my design. And as I said, this piece has to come apart. And for this, we're gonna be using size 1/2 inch male and female adapters for CPVC pipe. And this is actually going to be inserted inside of the pipe rather than going around, so it'll look naturally the same size. And for the top part, I ended up using the female adapter, applying epoxy, and then inserting it into the pipe, letting it dry overnight. And I then ended up covering it in Warbler as well, so it had the same look and was hidden. Now, Warbler has a bit of a grain-like surface texture to it. And how I like to get rid of it is by using Rust-Oleum's sandable filler. I use this also for 3D printed parts, and I apply heavy coat onto both sides of the surface, let it dry, and then I ended up wet sanding all of it so it would be nice and smooth and flush, and it's a lot easier than having to 3D print this whole piece. I did the same process probably 2 or 3 times until I was satisfied with how flat the surface looked. Now for the barbed wire that wraps around. And for this, I'm gonna be using 4mm EVA foam. I cut first a very long strip that was going to serve as the two that sit together. First, doing a halfway cut down the EVA foam, only piercing halfway through it. So that way, when I use a heat gun, that line will open up and it basically looks like two pieces. As well as I went to my workbench and I used a sanding drum to round the edges for all of the individual spikes. Next, I applied contact cement glue to where I was going to attach all the parts. And once the glue was dry, I started to wrap the individual burrs around, so it went 3 times. Followed by gluing it to the axe head. Next, for the spike parts, and I'll note that I went the lazy route and I 3D modeled and 3D printed these parts just because I hate making spikes out of foam, but you can always do this out of foam or out of Warbler, whatever you want. And this file is also available on my website, tiffanygordoncosplay.com, link in the description. And they just needed a little bit of cleanup after print, so I sanded them, did the whole sandable spray paint as well, and then epoxied it into the top part of the axe. And I designed it so that way it would fit perfectly inside of the 1-inch CPVC pipe. And again, let it dry overnight. Now for all of the details onto this piece. And I did a bunch of different sizes of EVA foam, starting off with a 6mm that I wrapped around, doing small details with my red 2mm EVA foam. And then I used 10mm EVA foam for the kind of bar-like pieces that go around. The axe does have a floating-like piece on the side with 2 bars that connect to it. And for these, I used 6mm EVA foam, and I used high density because this was more stiff and would be stronger than just normal EVA foam. Cutting it with an X-Acto knife, as well as using Costol's hole drills to make my rivet-like parts. Went to my workbench and sanded all of the edges with a sanding drum. And then glued it to the last piece of Warbler wrapped insulation foam. And now for the spring-like piece, which is a really interesting and fun thing, but it was also a little difficult to make. And for me, I did it with starting off with two circles. One was 1 inch, one was 3/4 inch out of 10 millimeter foam. And then I got a foam dowel rod and glued that into the center. And to give a floating-like look to a spring that's gonna wrap around, I'm gonna be using a half round foam dowel, as well as I'm gonna be sticking small little bits of 4 millimeter EVA foam to the center of the dowel rod. So that way it will help and give that levitating look to the spring. Starting off from the base, gluing it to the bottom, and then slowly gluing it to each of these spikes around the dowel rod until I got to the end. And the very last step for this section would be to glue this entire floating piece to the main part of the axe, and that completes the top half. Now for the bottom handle-like piece. And for this, I'm gonna be using 1 inch CPVC pipe as well as 2 inch CPVC pipe. And for this handle, there is a detailed grip-like piece. And for this, I kind of drew on my pattern shape and then I traced it onto 2 millimeter EVA foam as one sheet. And for all of the line grooves, I ended up just slightly piercing through the EVA foam, making sure not to pierce all the way through. We're doing the same technique where when you use a heat gun to apply heat to the surface, it's going to activate and all of those channels are gonna open up so you will see them. Then just apply your contact cement glue to both the pipe as well as to the back of the EVA foam. Let the two pieces fully dry and then you can attach them together. And there are a bunch of kind of rings that go around this piece. And for this, I ended up using Costool's circle cutter to cut Cheerio-like shapes out of 10 millimeter EVA foam, and then continued to add 2 millimeter EVA foam details all throughout the rest of the piece. And let's not forget about our giant spike at the bottom. And again, I'm using my 3D printed piece and I designed it as well to be insertable into a 1 inch thick CPVC pipe, attaching it with epoxy and letting it dry overnight, followed by gluing the 1 inch CPVC pipe inside the 2 inch CPVC pipe. And then last, to attach our male CPVC pipe adapter size 1/2 inch into the other side of the pipe. And I'll note for this piece that it is a 2 inch pipe on the opposite side that I used. So you will have to add some EVA foam on the inside for it to fit, or put another pipe of 1 inch inside of there. So that way it will align perfectly. But after that, it was complete. And that, guys, is how I made the axe. I hope you found this video helpful for making your very axe so you can also help to escort the payload. And if so, let me know in the comments, as well as don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. Also, a big thank you to all of my company sponsors here on YouTube, as well as all of those members here that help financially support me so I can continue doing this as my full-time job, specifically those legendary members. And I'll see you for our next video, which will be how I paint this. So stay tuned.